No, baby. Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm coming to you with yet another fail video, I guess. This one is a trim fail. I've only trimmed my hair myself like twice, and the last two times, the first two times, I trimmed it while it was wet, and I was thinking to myself, I really want to try trimming it dry, but I'm too lazy to like do all the heatless stretching and whatever, blow out whatever, and then start trimming. So I saw someone on Instagram with like really amazing twists and, you know, just like perfect goals twists, trimming her twist dry, and I was like, huh, okay, let me try that. So that's what I did, and that's what flopped for me. I'm calling it the reverse trim method because the last time I trimmed, as you guys saw, I pulled it straight, did this trimmy thing, twisted, and then trimmed a little extra if I saw any. This time I twisted everything, let it dry, and then trimmed anything that I saw in the coil. So I kind of recoiled it too to kind of pull the ends and make sure I saw everything. Then trim anything I saw in the coil of the twist. Then untwisted a little bit and then trimmed each side. So it was like I trimmed the coil first, then the hair, whereas before I trimmed the hair first, then the coil. Yes, I got it right. So yeah, so I'm calling it like the reverse dusting, reverse trim method, but it didn't really work for me. So pulling like this and trimming is a lot easier for me and makes a lot more sense for me because I'm not great at twisting anyway, and I'm not used to twists and coils and all of that and having to deal with that. So this easy peasy, but trying to deal with like a coil already doing its own thing and already set in a certain way and going sideways basically and trying to trim was just really hard, really difficult for me. So I kind of regretted it as soon as I started and saw what it was going to be like. For me, I want to just trim the damage and trim as little as possible, I guess. I don't want to just like be trimming off coils, especially since my hair is very coily and one little coil could be like 2 inches. So, you know, I wanted a little more precision, I guess, than that method gave. Plus, I wanted to be able to kind of cut straight-ish and not cut a coil that's going left while I'm trying to cut across. You know, it was just like too much going on. So, the pros of the method is trimming dry hair, because I really believe that it's better to trim hair that's not wet. Dry, but moisturized, not dried out. So not wet and not heat blown out, but if you did some kind of heatless stretch or something and trim that, I think that would be the healthiest state because your cuticles are like lower and it's not, the more raised your cuticles are while trimming, the more kind of damage you might be causing, and water raises the cuticles and heat raises the cuticles. Easier than like doing some kind of heatless stretch and then trimming, like a 3-step process, wash one day, heatless stretch the next day, trim the third day. It's easier than all that. And it's less tiring and stressful than trying to trim on wash day, because you know, after you go through your whole wash day, you don't want to start trimming. So I was like, this sounds good, let me try it, but not as easy as it looks. Not for those who just want to cut the bare minimum, not for those who kind of want to at least try to cut on a straight line, try to cut even and stuff like that. It is easier to see your ends and to see the damage when it's dry, so I was able to see it. It was just going in a coil when I was trying to cut it and just making my life difficult. So I guess you should think before you leap. So I leapt and then this is my final thoughts. So hopefully I'll save other people, unless you're really good at twisting and that's your dream and you do it that way and it works for you. But people who are like new to twisting, new to trimming, both like me, probably should leave that method alone. So next time I trim, I'm gonna go back to the way I was doing it, which is the way Natural 85 taught me how to do it. I'm gonna go back to that. I was thinking, would that be convenient to just cut and then have, you know, your twister with a nicely cut end? But I didn't cut like her. She just literally just took a coil and cut, and then she separated it and then kind of cut each coil. But she's really good at twisting, for one, so her coils were perfect, and for two, she didn't seem as concerned in terms of how much she cut. So she didn't cut much, but she cut just cutting bits of coil, whereas I wanted to kind of stretch out the coil and see exactly what I was cutting. So by the time I was done stretching out the end of my coil, I would say ruined my twist out, if it would have ever had a chance anyway, but it did kind of mess up my twist out. So me thinking, oh, I would just cut it just like her and have perfect twist just like her, dreams versus reality kind of thing. So I think for me, for intro, my twist out will come out better if I trim it wet or before and then coil it and just let it be at the end. I don't regret it. I mean, I needed a trim. I got a trim. As long as your hair shears are sharp and you don't cut too much, you can't really go wrong in terms of trimming. And it's just hair anyway, it'll grow back and all that. So I don't like hardcore regret it, but it wasn't the best trimming approach for me. So this is pretty much how much I cut. And in terms of the average length of it, it wasn't too bad either. So like, this is kind of in the range I'm going for when I trim, which is like, you know, quarter inch to half inch, I guess. So overall, I'm still glad I have a trim. I'm just saying that it wasn't the easiest way to do it. And my ends are probably all different lengths, all different situations going on in there right now. So I'll definitely be going back to that next time. So that's it. Let me know how you trim your hair. Let me know if you trim it yourself, and if you do, how you trim your hair. If you do like wet, if you do like pulling out like this, if you just freestyle, if you dust off of twists, like, let me know what you guys do. So I'll maybe have something new to try next time. I don't know. Maybe I should stick to what works. I don't know. But you know, I'm enjoying my journey, and I hope you are too. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.